Hi, I'm Bob. The textbook, Microeconomics, Theory and Applications with Calculus, is one of the most popular textbooks in microeconomics and is widely used in colleges and universities. Let's solve the exercises at the end of each chapter together. I use the fifth edition of the textbook. I will show you the step-by-step solutions for each problem. Some steps may not be necessary in the exam, but for interpretation purposes here, in this detailed tutorial, I will explain the logic of solving the exercises in more detail, and I hope it helps. Here's Chapter 2, Supply and Demand. The first part is about demand. Let's look at exercise 1.1. The estimated demand function for Canadian processed pork is as follows, where Q is the quantity in million kilograms of pork per year. P is the dollar price per kilogram. PB is the price of beef per kilogram. PC is the price of chicken in dollars per kilogram. And Y is the average income in thousands of dollars. What is the demand function if we hold PB, PC, and Y at their typical values during the period studied? First, the demand function shows the relationship between the quantity demanded and the price of the good, holding all other factors constant. The other factors influencing purchases include consumer tastes, information, income, prices of substitutes and complements, and government rules and regulations. Second, to hold the beef and chicken prices and income constant, we substitute those values into the equation and write the quantity demanded as a function of only the price of pork. The demand function for pork is Q equals 286 minus 20 times P. Let's do the exercise 1.2. Using the estimated demand function for processed pork from exercise 1.1, show how the quantity demanded at a given price changes as per capita income Y increases by $100 a year. We take the first derivative of quantity demanded with respect to the income to find the marginal change in quantity as income increases by one unit, holding the other variables constant. It is 2, meaning that as income increases by one unit, the quantity demanded increases by 2 units. The change in income is $100. Notice that the unit of income is $1,000. Then we have the answer of 0.2 million kilograms per year. Let's solve exercise 1.3. Given an estimated demand function for avocados, show how the demand curve shifts as per capita income Y increases from $4,000 to $5,000 per month. Illustrate this shift in a diagram. First, we hold the price of tomatoes constant at $0.8 by substituting the value into the equation. In the second step, we obtain the demand functions for the two incomes by substituting the income values into the equation. Now, we have the equations for the two demand curves. In the final step, we draw the graph. We usually put the price on the y-axis. We know that the two demand curves are parallel because they have the same slope. we can plug in particular values, such as p equals 0, to find the intersection points in the quantity axis and the price axis. The demand curve shifts to the right by 10 units in quantity as income increases from $4,000 to $5,000, holding the other variables fixed. Keep in mind that the demand curve we draw is the inverse demand function because the y-axis is the price and x-axis is the quantity demanded. But it is a convention to call it the demand curve. Let's find the answer to exercise 1.4. Suppose that the demand function for movies is Q1 equals 120 minus P for college students and Q2 equals 60 minus 0.5 P for other town residents. What is the town's total demand function? Carefully draw a figure to illustrate your answer. The total quantity demanded at a given price is the sum of the quantity each consumer demands at that price. That is, we add the demand curves horizontally. So the town's total demand function is Q equals 180 minus 1.5 times P. The total demand curve is a downward sloping straight line. It is the horizontal sum of the two demand curves. Let's solve exercise 1.5. The food and feed demand curves used in the application aggregating corn demand curves were estimated as follows. Mathematically, derive the total demand curve. The total quantity demanded at a given price is the sum of the quantity each consumer demands at that price. That is, we add the demand curves horizontally. In the second step, we find the particular values in the graph. If we set the feed quantity equal to 0, we find that the price is 27.56. If we set the food quantity equal to 0, we find that the price is 67.29. If we set the price equal to 0, the feed quantity demanded is 6,247.5. If we set the price equal to 0, the food quantity demanded is 1,487. We can now draw the two demand curves. The two demand curves intersect. The feed demand curve hits the price axis at $27.56. When the price is above $27.56, the feed demand will be zero, because it's too expensive for farmers to use corn to feed animals. So the part of the total demand curve where the price is above 27.56 is the same as the food demand curve. The part of the total demand curve where the price is below 27.56 is the horizontal sum of the two demand curves. The aggregate demand curve has a kink. The corresponding total demand function is as follows. Let's do the last exercise for part 1 of chapter 2. Based on information in the application, the demand elasticities for Google Play and Apple apps, the demand function for mobile applications at the Apple App Store is QA equals 1.4 times P to the power minus 2, and the demand function at Google Play is 1.4 times P to the power minus 3.7. where the quantity is in millions of apps. What is the total demand function for both firms? If the price for an app is $1, what is the equilibrium quantity demanded by Apple customers, Google customers, and all customers? The total demand is the horizontal sum of the two individual demands. If the price is $1, we substitute 1 into the demand functions and we have the quantities demanded for the Apple customers, the Google customers, and all customers. In addition, if you are curious about the shape of the demand curves, you can use data to draw the curves. Please check out my videos on Stata graphics to learn more about it. Here are the demand curves for Apple apps and Google apps. We see that the demand curve for Apple apps is steeper than the Google apps. When the price is $1, the quantity demanded is the same for both curves. To plot the curves, we should write down the inverse demand function first, that is, the price as a function of the quantity demanded. Thank you very much for solving the exercises with me. See you soon in the next part of Chapter 2. Goodbye. Thank you for watching this video and subscribing to my YouTube channel. See you next time.